Gene therapy isn't dead yet. If you talk to some people that used to work with it in the past, they would think that, okay, it's just a really complicated issue dealing with trying to challenge the patient's immune system with delivering a specially designed therapy. Well, there were in the past a couple of patients on the dying in clinical trials, and a lot of people kind of got scared of the technology, and they kind of took a step back. Well, knowing a little bit more about our immune system now, because those patients, they wound up succumbing to their therapy in the late 90s, we know more about the immune system now, and then we also have a couple of new tools. So we've studied the vectors that we use in gene therapy, which are essentially kind of like parts of viruses. So if you can imagine, if you could put the part or the coat of one virus, you can essentially give that therapy the tropism or the targeting ability of that virus. So let's say if we're talking about a lentivirus like HIV, HIV attacks certain cells in the blood called CD4 white blood cells or T cells. If you are giving an AAV or an adeno-associated virus vector, you can target different cell types like the liver, for example. And so that's the code part. This other new technology that we have, which is really cool, is something called CRISPR-Cas9, which essentially lets us...